Good evening, this is Dion Hubert. It's Monday evening, about 11 o'clock on the 4th of May. I feel the urge to make this video, although I haven't done something like this in the past. But with the latest development in the pandemic, the so-called pandemic, I'm frustrated because I see a lot of people that think that this pandemic is really a pandemic, although it's the biggest bullshit lie that I've ever seen in my entire life. Let me tell you why. In this lockdown period in South Africa, I've heard Cyril Ramaphosa said the other evening on live television that they have obtained 500 billion rand to bail out South African people that's been harmed by this lockdown. My question, first question is, where did he get it? Where was this this money being obtained? From which company, which country, where? The second thing that I can say is that Bill Gates has been in contact just prior to that with Mr. Ramaphosa. So Mr. Ramaphosa came out on live television and he said that because we are part of a couple of entities like the Brexit and all those the SADC companies, the SADC countries and so on, that we will be also joining the New World Order. So what he said, I think less than 5% of humanity understood, in South Africa, understood what he was mentioning about. He said that we're going to join the New World Order. So what is the New World Order? I've been speaking about this New World Order that is developing around us for the last couple of years, 2 years, 2.5 years. And nobody could understand what I was saying. They thought I had a loose screw or something. Is not. I'm a little bit mindfucked, if I can use that word. So let me explain this to you in a couple of minutes. The New World Order will be the new norm and standard. If you don't know what the New World Order is, listen to me, I will explain to you. The New World Order will be a one world government. It will be a one world religion. The government will decide where you can go. He will decide what you can do. He will decide what you can earn. It's communism in a worldwide scale. If you don't understand that at this point in time, you're going to wake up in a couple of months from now with a total mind-boggling experience. So let me tell you where this comes from. W.J. Bush, George Bush, was WJ was his father, but George Bush came out in 2005 and he said that the new world order will be implemented very soon. Not in the exact words, but that's what it boiled down to. So prior to that, what was the new world order? What was it about? When was it decided? Let me take you back to the Second World War. People that was alive prior to 1938 will maybe start to understand what I'm trying to tell you now. In 1938, it was the start of the Second World War in the recent time period of history. The Second World War ended around about 1935. In 1938, of 1945, 1948 is one of the most dates that you have to start recognizing what happened. In 1948, a couple of things developed. There was a new United Nations body that was created. This was a lot of countries together that created this body. This is also actually the new world order. That was the starting point of the new world order, the last phase of the new world order. Implementing with the new world order a division called the World Health Organization, also created in 1948. Now, I think up until that point in time, health was still very good. Everybody was quite healthy. And the question is, why was such a body needed? Maybe the flu of 1918, that might be a reason, but the flu in 1918 and a little bit later, I think in 1928-32, there was also a little bit of a pandemic, but not as much as 1918. Now in 1948, this body came into existence. My question is, why? But I will tell you. Let's take it back to 1880 and just prior to 1880. There was a person with the name Albert Pike. Albert Pike was a 33 degree Freemason. He was also recognized as a magician of his time. Albert Pike explained in his way how the new world order will come into existence and how Satan will be ruling over the earth. Right. Albert Pike was somebody, I'm not sure what his name is. It was a marine in Australia that liked to write books. Now, he written in 1980 a book containing all the information about the First World War, the Second World War, and the Third World War. And then getting Lucifer on the throne, ruling over this world. Okay, so if you don't know what a Freemason is, let me tell you. A Freemason is a person that is occupied in a secret organization. It's not actually a secret organization, but more an organization that has got a lot of secrets. The Freemasons and the Illuminati is the same entity in two different aspects of the world. The Illuminati has got 33 degrees, just as the Freemasons, which they start off at level 1 and they have to progress until the level of 33. Now let me give you a little bit of background what this 33 actually boils down to, and to connect it with a couple of other points that might interest you. For some it might just be a lot of woo-woo things, like most of the people that I speak to, they think I'm a bit crazy. But let me tell you, there's three points on this earth that is on the 33 degree longitude line. The first one is Egypt, the Giza plateau with the pyramids on the 33rd degree longitude. The second one is the ruins in Zimbabwe, also on the 33 degree longitude. The third one is Adam's calendar. Now, I know most of you won't even know what is Adam's calendar. Let me tell you, Adam's calendar is a stone circle that's about the same age, if it's not older, than Stonehenge. It's situated about 4 kilometers south of a little town near Nelspruit called Kaapse Hoop. Now, in this area, there's been an ancient gold mine experience recorded, of which this stone circle predicted the time of the year and the winter and summer solstices. So if you think that this 33 degree longitude has got nothing to do with the Freemasons, then let me take you to your backbone. How many bones have you got in your vertebrae, have you got in your body? If you don't know, it's 33. The following, or the next 33 timeline or number will come up if I ask you, how old were Jesus when he started preaching? And you would say 30 years of age, roughly. Then I would ask you, how old was he when he died? The same number comes up, 33 years. Is this all just a coincidence? I doubt it. So Albert Pike was a magician. And if you think that the magician, there's no magicians, then think again. I can tell you, for the Christians out there that don't believe what I'm saying and do not only believe in Christianity and that's the full and final version of religion for them, let me take you to Matthew 6 verse 22 to 24, which states that the eye, the lamp of the body, is the eye. If the eye be single, the whole body will be full of light. If the eye be dark, the whole body will be full of darkness. And then it continues to say that you can't obey two masters? It's either God or money in your religion. So this will take me back to a point that I will explain to you now in the Emerald Tablets of Thoth. Now, if you, most of you would know or will agree if I say that if you sit with and you think of Satanism, then it's real. They do blood sacrifices and they do whatever they want to do, and they have got power. So what happened to the Christianity's part of the power? Let me tell you, it's the same thing. The power that the Satanists use to create what they create is the same power that we have got to create what we need to create. The lamp of the body is the eye. If the eye be single, it's a singular eye. I tell you, it's a third eye. Now, I know there's a lot of you that will start thinking of switching off this video at this point in time, stopping it if you haven't done so already. But listen me out. It states, if the eye be single, the whole body will be full of light. If the eye be dark, the whole body will be full of darkness. So you've got a dark magician like Albert Pike that offers blood and sacrifices and create what he wants to create. And you can also have the white magician, the light magician, that stands in opposite of this Albert Pike. Now, I'm not sure who it is, but it must be all of us. And if you haven't started to question your belief system, then tell me, if you sit in church on a Sunday, although we can't go to church anymore, if that right has been taken away from you, it's not coming back. I can tell you that. It's not coming back. I promise you, if you're not going to wake up, that time is gone. So, how many of you are sitting in church, but before you go to church, you have to take a handful of pills just to feel good enough so that you can actually attend church? And then you say, you think by yourself, you are holy. Now, let me tell you, if you can give me a definition of holiness other than what I'm giving you now, I would like to hear it. So, my definition of holiness, it comes from Romans 12, verse 1. I'm not going to be able to give you the exact phrases, but it goes something like this. You have to keep your body holy, acceptable unto God. That is your religion. It states that. That is your religion. So now there's a lot of people mugging around, stating that their religion is the one and true religion, and there's nothing else. But I would like to differ from you. I was there from when I could remember until about 26 years of age. Then I started again around about 33 years of age, and I stopped around about 47 years of age, 48 maybe. In that point where I thought my religion was the only religion that there was. So What it boils down to, everything is the same thing. Christianity, politics, economy, everything. Conspiracy, everything has got to do with one another. You can't talk about the one and exclude the other. It's all one thing. And you have to understand that. If you... I want to take you back to the Emerald Tablets of Thoth. Emerald Tablets of Thoth is believed to be 36,000 years old. If you want to know what it is, go and investigate it for yourself. Emerald Tablets of Thoth, T-H-O-T-H. He said that he was Thoth the Atlantean. So he was in Atlantis. And at a point in time in Atlantis, there were people, magicians, that started calling up the beings from the underworld by sacrificing blood. Now, I would say this is not your sheep and deer that was offered. This was people. Okay? And I'm going to come back to the people and what is happening with Trump at this specific point in time. But I know that to swallow this is going to be very hard. So what happens, what happened in that, and in that time period, is that these entities called up these beings from the underworld by sacrificing blood. That is Satanism. It comes from ancient eons ago. And you think Satanism started in around about Jesus' time, or just before that with the Hebrews. No, it comes from ancient times. Then they went into a spaceship. This is now where you're going to think I'm woo-woo. They climb into a spaceship. I'm going to show you now. I'm going to give you indication of, okay, I will put this in a different spot where I'm gonna show you. Atlantis is believed to be on the western side of Africa, on that ear. The elephant's ear. Africa looks like an elephant's ear. On the left-hand side, right on top, there's the furthest point you will see, I will show you, there's concentric circles, which they believe was the ancient Atlantis before the flood. And there was a flood. And the entity there, the God entity, told Thoth to take the spaceship, put his people in the spaceship, and go to the land of Ken. As they started rising, the water came and took away Atlantis underneath them. They flew in the spaceship, he mentions, into the rising sun. That means from the western side of Africa, they flew across to the eastern side, into the rising sun. And they came to a point where there were people that was mocking them with cudgels and spears. And they settled in the land of Ken. Now, the land of Ken, to give you an indication, is Egypt. Now, if you go and listen to Santos Bonecci, he will explain to you from Egypt how the banksters that created the wealth for themselves started in Egypt, then they proceeded onto Venetia, then into Rome, then into the United Nations, and the rest of Europe. Now show me one black person. Just one. That has got to do with banking. I'm talking about the elites, the very rich. There's none. All are white. Okay? Right. So they came from one point and they started this banking situation. In Rome, they started with the Vatican, but the Roman Empire started infiltrating Israel first. And they destroyed Israel at the time of Jesus' time, when Jesus lived there. And they were occupying a whole area or a big part of the world at that point in time, of which this little area was also under their control. Now, that was around about 2020 years back, as we could calculate it from our calendar. Now, about 1,650 years back, the Roman Empire knew that they're going to collapse. Like South Africa knew the last couple of years that we are collapsing. And don't think that what's happening in South Africa is loose from what's happening in the world today. It's the same thing. If you wake up to what I'm saying, you will understand it's one thing. So what happened with this empire? It was busy collapsing, and they decided to make a religion. The Christ religion that they got in Israel, where they actually killed the people that the believers. Now they instating this 350 years later to work for them. Why? Because they wanted to enforce stability in the Roman Empire. In the end, they couldn't. The empire got lost. But the Roman Catholic Church is still there. That is Rome. They are still ruling from that little Vatican that they are hiding themselves in. They talk about the Crusades that started a while after the Bible was given to the whole world as the religion of the time. And you're not allowed to get religion from anywhere else. So if you think that your Bible that you are reading is free of this satanic bullshit, then think again, because it's not. The Roman Empire started accumulating books. They decided which books will be included. They decided which books will be excluded. There were a lot of books that they got from the Dead Sea Scrolls, that was actually meant to be included in the Bible, but it was left out. And if you go through the book, the Gospel of Thomas, you will understand why it's been left out. Because it gives you the indication that if you put your mind and your heart and you fuse it, you've got the ability to fuse it, like Albert Pike, then you can create your future. Go and check it out for yourself. The Lost Gospel of Thomas. One guy that explains it very, very well is Greg Braden. Go and look up Greg Braden, The Lost Gospel of Thomas. He will explain to you 100% what's been left out in our Bible and what the verse actually reads. So Let's continue to the Crusades. Now, the Crusades was there to get rid of all human history of your Christ consciousness. But if you read the Crusades and so on, you will read that there were magicians and witches, and they were bad people, and they were killed, and all their literature were burned, and so on. That's a lie. The magicians and the witches that they are talking about were people called the Essenes that was actually lifting themselves to be able to create their future, and they were seen as the white magicians. Now, why were they killed? Because the Roman Empire was afraid of what they could do to the empire. Remember now, those people lived in love and harmony. But they were mocked as to be witches and magicians. That's why they were killed. The Roman Empire has got an empire. They are the wealthiest group of people in this world. And your body has been enslaved to them without your knowledge. I will tell you, maybe I'll get to that. I'm sitting at half an hour already. So, where does the 40 of the 84 kilometers of books that's in the basement of the Vatican, where did it come from? I can tell you, a lot of that came from the Crusades, the books of the witches and the magicians that they've stolen, burnt a couple of them, and the rest they stole. They brought it back to the Vatican. The other part they stole from Alexandria in Egypt. And after they've stolen what they wanted to have, they burned down that, what do you call a bibliothek? But anyway, they burned down the building where all of these books were kept.